Your favorite movies and TV shows are under a major threat of censorship in India right now, and we need you to start fighting to save the creative arts. Netflix, Prime, Hotstar, etc. are basically what we call OTT or over-the-top streaming platforms. On these platforms, you don't have to wait like you do on cable news for a whole week to pass to watch your favorite shows. Instead, you can just log on to the internet and binge-watch Seema Aunty whenever, wherever, for however long you want. OTT platforms in this way are totally game-changing and super convenient. But of course, there's an issue. OTT platforms have realized that there are certain themes in shows that the people of India or government of India might find offensive. Now, this can be an LGBT character or a political joke or a really hard-hitting investigative documentary on something like corruption, whatever. Think Tandav or Mirzapur. A lot of busybodies and uncles and people who are very sensitive about religious and cultural issues have been putting pressure on the government, saying you need to start regulating OTT platforms. You need to start telling them what they can or cannot stream. In around 2020, platforms realized this and they were like, okay, hold on, don't regulate us. We don't want to put out offensive content and have people get angry or potentially even be forced to take it down by the government via legal notices. Instead, let us ourselves decide what kind of non-offensive content we put out and let's follow these rules by ourselves. This will, you know, keep government regulation at bay and it'll keep us in good stead with the government and it'll make business easy. So in February 2020, along with the Internet and Mobile Association of India, an industry body, a bunch of OTT platforms adopted a voluntary self-regulation code that actually laid down these rules. 17 platforms adopted this by September 2020, but unfortunately it wasn't really perfectly implemented because both OTT platforms and the Ministry of Information and Broadcasting weren't too happy with it. Then recently, in a dramatic series of events, Tandav created furore over offensive content. So this month, the Ministry of Information and Broadcasting Minister Prakash Javadekar was basically like, yeah, enough is enough. We've been receiving a lot of complaints, so the central government will come out with guidelines for regulating OTT platforms. We're gonna do it. Right after he said that, the Internet and Mobile Association of India was like, wait, no, we're getting really serious about self-imposed regulation. And in fact, we've come out with a toolkit that will help implement the self-regulation code and it will also provide a robust mechanism for addressing grievances related to content. And it will make sure that OTT platforms carry out their responsibilities with regards to regulation. Basically, they were like, we'll be so good at regulating our own content that the government won't need to regulate us. So, this toolkit has just been announced and we're yet to know whether the center will actually move towards regulating OTT platforms or not. Let's get down to the real issue. This voluntary self-regulation is essentially self-censorship that OTT platforms are being forced to do because of their fear of persecution and because they don't want government over-regulation to happen. It's a terrible bargain. Imagine, it's basically like saying, I'll put a clamp on myself before you put a clamp on me anyway. And the outcome of both these things is the same, which is the silencing of new and progressive ideas. If this happens, everyone will be affected. Actors, production companies, OTT platforms, and anybody who wants to bring new and novel ideas into video. You won't be able to see a lot of content because in a country of 1.3 billion people, a lot of things are considered offensive. And the same regulations that are put on TV will be put on OTT platforms and you'll get the same tired and old and boring content. And while no doubt there are people who like watching, you know, Ba, Bahu or Baby, we still want the choice to watch other things. Not to forget, there are cultural and economic harms as well. Today, India is doing really well in the video space and we're becoming internationally recognized. We're even competing with other countries, like for example with K-dramas. But we have all of these restrictions, that's not going to happen. Yet another issue is the problem of discretionary power. Last year, the Ministry of Information and Broadcasting was made the key ministry under which the regulation of online media happens. Now, they don't technically have the legal authority to actually cause censorship, but we're afraid it'll happen anyway. They'll become like a post office for hurt sentiments where people will send their grievances about offensive content. And this is totally possible given the massive catalogs of OTT platforms. OTT platforms already have lots of restrictions on them because they have to constantly comply with criminal laws like hate speech and obscenity and so on. You know what I'm talking about. And also the OTT sector is really competitive right now. So they have to take out, you know, content which people will like, which will become popular and which will allow them to recover their investments. You may be wondering, are traditional TV and cinema regulations really all that bad? And I mean, yeah, they're kind of archaic because we got them in earlier India where consuming media was more of a public act and people would get together and watch films and shows in a far more conservative society. But things have really changed since then. We watch our OTT platform shows on our phones and laptops at home in, you know, private. And so we can't have these creaky old censorship models be put onto these fresh and new and exciting ideas like OTT platforms. As you can see, there's a lot going on in the OTT khichdi in India right now. So what can you do to help? At IFF, we've been working on this issue for some time now. Our staff members have been filing RTIs, representing your rights and cases in courts, presenting representations to your relevant ministries and so on. What we really need from you is to start paying attention to this issue and to spread the word amongst your friends and family. At IFF, we are completely supported by regular Indians like you who make donations to us, and we really need your support so that we can continue fighting for your rights. So please consider donating to the Internet Freedom Foundation.